Hey, this is Dr. Joe Feuerstein with the MD Minute. Thanks for tuning in. And today I want to talk about a study that was just published in the International Journal of Obesity looking at a very well-known supplement that is a naturally occurring substance we've all heard of called resveratrol and obesity. So resveratrol is a substance, it's a polyphenol, it's found in high concentrations in red wine, it's also found in dark chocolate, nuts and berries. It's a great substance in very healthy foods, and it's been seen as a panacea for lots of different medical problems, including longevity, living forever for many years. Unfortunately, there's an NIH trial that looked at the population in Italy taking resveratrol, and they found very little evidence that taking resveratrol would increase your longevity, and this was a 2014 trial. So resveratrol, as a result of that, has become a little bit less favorable. However, this new study is very intriguing. What they did, it was done in rats, it was done in mice, is that they fed female mice a lot of fat in their diet. And when you feed female mice fat, they get fat. However, half the mice were also given resveratrol. The other half were just given a fatty meal. And what they found was that if the mouse was given fatty food with resveratrol, the risk of becoming obese was reduced by 40%. The neat part of the study was that they then analyzed, by taking biopsies, what was actually happening to this fat. And what they found is that resveratrol seemed to turn the fat in the mouse from white fat, which is not good fat, to the very important brown fat, which actually is important to keep your body temperature. It's a, like almost like a generator which burns off lots of calories and is seen in mammals who hibernate and also seen in newborns. It's brown fat that's the stuff that will help burn off all the extra calories, burn off all the extra fat. And so they found that taking the resveratrol seemed to change the white fat into the more beneficial brown fat. Now, my take on this is that we are talking about mice. This is not done in humans yet, but it's very interesting to see where potentially resveratrol could go. Dr. Joe Feuerstein with the MD Minute. Thanks for tuning in.